All right, in this video, we're still talking about field data and collecting that in Bluebeam Revu. You guys can check out some of my other videos where I talk about customizing symbols and collecting RFIs. I'll put those links up above. But today we're gonna go through some tips and tricks for collecting the field data. So we're gonna talk about spaces, custom columns, some status, legends, and then we'll finish out with summary reports. So here we go. To start out, we're going to go to the spaces toolbar over here. If you don't have it, just go down to the black area, right click, go to show, and go down to spaces, or the alt s is going to be that shortcut. So we're going to go to that tool panel over here, and then we're just going to click on the plus, add space. And this is a lot like doing area measurements. You can do it in a couple different ways. You can zoom in here and click onto the corners and just drag that out. It's gonna ask you for the name. We're gonna call this meeting 214. Say okay. Next one we'll do is this one here. You can also pick on the corners and do it like a polygon. You get over to this final corner, just double click. Call that meeting 216. And then another trick you can do is also we can use dynamic fill. So if you come over here to the measure tab, click on dynamic fill, it's going to open up a new toolbar down here. Pull that up to the top. So you want to go ahead and select the spaces so that it reports that for us. And then we're going to go into our add a boundary. Dynamic fill requires a continuous line all the way around the perimeter. So we're pick, double click, and then I'm going to select my paint bucket. Double check I've got my spaces selected, and then I just go ahead and pour paint in here. And when I'm done, I hit apply. And over here, this time I need to double click and actually name that meeting 215. Okay, so I can do it that way. I can also do it maybe not as precise if I come in to create another space. If I do the polygon along here, maybe just pick on a couple spaces here, double click, meeting 217, say okay. So what Spaces does for us now is it knows what room these are. So any markups that we place, if I go to my tool set again, and I start to place these cabinetry tools within these spaces, it actually knows what room it's in. So you can look down here at our markups list, and we can sort this by space. So if I click on the top of the space column, you'll see that there's one in each room, so it's going to report those. If I start placing additional ones in here, you'll see all the markups for that particular room. So if you've got a big project and you want to know everything that needs to be done in a certain room, you can do it by space. So there's also an option in here if you add a space around the others, completely encompassing the other spaces. So maybe this is like a west wing or something like that. We can call it that. So let's just call this west wing and say okay. And you'll notice that it sets that up in a tree now. So all the west wing and the rooms within it are here. And it does the same thing down here in your markups list, west wing dashed meeting 214. So that's a great way to indicate where these markups are going to be. The next thing that I want to show you is custom columns. So down here in the bottom, I'm going to go ahead and go to columns and manage columns and create a custom one. And here I just want to add a responsibility column, and then I'm going to make it a choice. And I'm going to see who's paying attention to my videos here. I'm going to put a couple people in here. Go response in there, say okay. And now we've got three choices for our responsibility. I'm gonna say okay, okay here. And now you'll notice way on this other side that we've got a responsibility category. So what we can do is go ahead and grab some of these cabinetry ones, go over to the properties bar over here again and scroll down to where it says responsibility. Now we have a custom area and I can come in here and set this to Doug. And now he's in charge of all of the cabinetry. So now I can go through again and assign some to other people and so on. But I can again sort this list now by responsibility. So it'll group all of the ones that Doug's in charge of. I can also filter this list to only show the ones that Doug is in charge of. And then that will hide everything else off the list. You'll see up here that all of the other markups that are in here are actually grayed out. So they're not drawing any attention anymore. So only the ones that Doug is going to work on are lit up over on this side in color. Okay, so that's the responsibility column. The next thing I'll talk about is status. So when Doug goes through and he makes sure that he's finished these markups, he can come in here to the markups list, double click, and mark it completed. And he can come through as he completes these, mark them all complete. If Doug wants to, he could also filter by the blank section so that when he completes them, his list is actually going to empty. So he can go in, double click, complete it, and empty out his list. Okay, so I'm going to show all again here. And then what I can do, if I'm the project manager, Doug said he's done with all these, I could come in and reject it. It keeps all of these statuses in here. You can't remove those. But what I would do just to try to keep progress here, if I rejected that, I would actually right click on it, go down to reply, and tell him why it's broken. Please replace. Okay, so now that becomes a line item right underneath that markup so that we can communicate back and forth. The next thing I want to show you is legends. If I come over to our tool chest again, come in here, click on the little gear, and go down to legend, create new legend, and then you can build that out to look the way that you want, report the information you want. It's only going to report what's in this tool chest. And then what I recommend, a little trick, is to actually save that to your tool chest. So you can click on this, come out, and place that on your sheet. So it's only going to report the ones from this tool set that were used, none of the rest of them. And you just set this up in the properties over here. Oops. Set up the look of it, the appearance, and then you can go in as well and edit columns and select what you want to see. So on this one, we want the description and we want the comments in there. And then up here, you can also rename that legend because it's going to pull in a default one if you just go to the create legend. But I always like to set this all up the way that I want it and then just simply right click, add it to your tool chest and put it into that tool set with all the tools that belong to it. So a little tip there. The last thing I want to go over is the summary. So I'm going to minimize these. I have to remind myself to minimize those all the time. If I go down to my markups list, now that I have all of these in my markups list, I can create a summary report. I just come up here, click on summary, go to PDF summary. It's going to pull up my markup summary window where I can go and select the columns that I want to report and so on. And then I want to pick my output. So on here, I'm going to go ahead and insert my letterhead. So I'm going to load that in. This actually allows you to adjust the size of the report. So what's going to fit on this piece of paper. It's kind of cool when you import it. So I'll set that up. I'm going to say okay. And now that's loaded here. And then I always like to select the append and hyperlink current PDF. And then I'm just going to click okay. And it's going to go through and create a report real quick for me. You'll see if you look at the thumbnails, it's actually attached to that drawing. So we can come in here and look at our markups and see all the information that's in the custom columns down below. And then it gives you a thumbnail as well where that markup is in the drawing. And if you click on it, it'll bring you directly to that place in the drawing. So those are the tips and tricks that I wanted to show you guys. That's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. We're gonna pick here and double click there. Oops, let's try that over. Clear boundary.